This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. This is part one of degree measures of angles, and you should already be familiar with basic terminology for angles. And in this video, we're going to define the degree measure of an angle, as well as the meaning of these four different types of angles: acute angle, obtuse angle, right angle, and straight angle. So the most common unit for measuring angles is the degree. Most people have heard of degrees when they're measuring angles. There are other ways of measuring angles, but degree is certainly the first that most people hear about. And this was discovered around 2000 BCE, I don't know, plus or minus probably a few hundred years. I don't know exactly when it was. But they assigned 360 degrees to a complete rotation of a ray. So this is how we write degrees, this little symbol right here. So if you want 360 degrees, you write 360, and then you put this little symbol up here, that means degrees. So if you look at this angle in standard form here, here's the initial side, and then if we rotate, we go all the way around and back to where we start, that's a full rotation, and we call that a full 360 degree rotation. So we say this angle here that you see, it's kind of funny, it's a full rotation, you can have an angle like that, is 360 degrees. You might have heard of somebody referring to somebody doing a jump off a diving board as doing a 360, and that would mean like a full revolution before they dive in, etc. So if a complete revolution is 360 degrees, then half of a full revolution would be what? Well, we'd have half of 360 degrees, which is 180 degrees. So let's see what that looks like. That would be half of a revolution. So let's see. Let's say here is our angle, and here's where it ends. Okay? So right here is the middle part of it. And from here to here, that would be 180 degrees. So how many degrees is 1/4 of a full revolution? What do you think that would be? Well, we'd have 1/4 of a full revolution. Full revolution is 360, and so 1/4 of that would be 90 degrees. So what does that look like? What's a 90 degree angle look like? And my guess is you've probably seen that before. So 1/4 of a revolution would be you start here at the x-axis and you go only 1/4 of the way around, and so then this would be 90 degrees, this angle you see right here. Now it's common for a 90 degree angle to be written, let's see, like this. So let's say I wanted to do this one again. Often to denote that it's 90 degrees, they put a little square here. What it's saying, it's sort of squared off. 90 degrees is the angle, and all four angles in a square have 90 degrees. So you'll see this little box to denote a 90 degree angle. Okay? So that's another way of writing a 90 degree angle. That's the notation that's often used as opposed to this little arrow, all right? But in any case, we've got that 1/4 of a revolution would be 90 degrees. And this angle is called, 90 degrees is called a right angle. Okay? Okay. So how many degrees is 1/6 of a full revolution? And then try drawing one in standard position. So what would that be? 1/6 of a full revolution would be 1/6 of 360 degrees, which is 60 degrees. Hopefully you're okay with this. I'm just reducing. 6 goes into 360, 60. Now what would that look like? So it's 1/6 of a full revolution. Here's the way I think of it. Well, from here to here, right, all the way over here. That's 180 degrees. That is half a revolution. And now I want 60 degrees. That's one third of that. So I think of this as one third of the 180 degrees. That's how I think of it. So if I think from here to here is 180, then I have to think of that of a third. So imagine if you broke it up into thirds. Can you see? There's an angle. There's an angle. There's an angle. So each of those would be about 60 degrees. Now I'm just freehanding it. That's not exactly 60 degrees, but I'm giving you a basic look as how I would come up with something like this. All right, that's one way of doing it. Other people think of it as well. If this from the right angle is from here to here is 90 degrees, then they break this up into thirds, 30, 30, and 30 more, and that's how they might come up that about that far is 60 degrees. So in any case, your 60 degrees should look something like this, about that far up. So that would be the angle. Now, you don't usually also draw it down here, but you could. So usually you just see where it starts on the axis, and you don't have to draw that part, but you show the terminal side of the angle. Now, this angle I drew here, 60 degrees, notice it's the way when you first learned about angles, how you think of an angle. You don't think of these full revolution type ones. It's an angle between 0 and 90 degrees, right? 60 degrees. And an angle between 0 and 90 degrees is called an acute angle. So an angle between 0 degrees and 90 degrees is called an acute angle. Now, I didn't really talk about 0 degrees. That would mean just here on the x-axis, it doesn't move at all. All right, so 0 degrees is just right here. It doesn't move. It's terminal and its initial side are exactly the same place. It doesn't move anywhere. You won't see an arrow at all. Okay, so I hadn't really explicitly talked about that. So we've got an acute angle. We found out like an angle that goes up 90 degrees, that's called a right angle. So we have a right angle and an acute angle. Let's move on to the next kind, special type of angle. All right, so how about if I draw an angle that is 135 degrees? So let's just keep in mind what we have come up with so far. We found out that if I went, you know, up to here, you know, in other words, from there to there, that was 90 degrees. And I want to get 135 degrees, so I've got to go more than 90 degrees. Now, how much more do I have to go? Well, 135 degrees minus 90 degrees, I've got 45 degrees more to go. And 45 degrees is, well, that's half of 90, so I've got half of this way more to go. So if I keep going a little bit further to here, that would be an estimate of where 135 degrees is. So let's see. So my 135 degree angle would be kind of going through the center here. So that's what an angle of 135 degrees goes to. And so, you know, you could estimate where a lot of, you know, angles are by doing that kind of reasoning. Now, this angle here is kind of big. It's not between 0 and 90. It's bigger than 90 degrees. It still kind of looks like an angle. So if I don't pat it, you know, if I just take it outside and look, it still looks like an angle. It doesn't look that funny like the ones that go all the way around, right? And we call an angle between 90 and 180 degrees an obtuse angle. So an angle between 90 degrees and 180 degrees is called an obtuse angle. So we've got an obtuse angle, we talked about an acute angle, we talked about a right angle. Now the first angle we looked at was 180 degrees. Let's look back at that. So here was our 180 degree angle, that was half of a full revolution. And we call this a straight angle. An angle that is 180 degrees is simply called a straight angle because it just looks like a straight line. Now, We could use capital letters to use for the angles A, B, C, D, E, but it's also common to use some Greek letters. These are some common ones, theta, alpha, and beta. And so I'm using those in this little picture here. So here's an example of an acute angle, theta. It's small, between 0 degrees and 90 degrees. The right angle is exactly 90 degrees. That's alpha here. An obtuse angle is a pretty big angle, but not all the way to 180 degrees. So it's bigger than 90, right? It's wide open, but it's less than 80 degrees. That's an obtuse angle. And a straight angle, the one we just talked about, is when it makes a straight line, it's exactly 180 degrees. This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.